Hey, what's going on, traders? In this video, we're going to be utilizing the power of artificial intelligence in order to make ourselves some custom trading indicators in the Thinkorswim platform from TD Ameritrade. Now, in order to make these custom indicators in Thinkorswim, you have to be familiar with Thinkorswim's coding language, which is known as ThinkScript. And if you're like me and you don't know much about coding at all, this looks very complicated, but luckily that's where artificial intelligence is going to come into play. We don't have to do any of this for ourselves. We simply have to come up with the indicator that we want the artificial intelligence to make for us, and then we're just going to copy and paste that code here into Thinkorswim. Okay, so what ChatGPT is an artificial intelligence robot that you can essentially have do just about anything imaginable for you. This is great for online marketing and online business specifically because, for example, you could have it write a 1,000-word blog post about a certain topic that includes specific keywords that are going to help your blog post rank highly on Google. Another example, if you're an online marketer, would be you can have ChatGPT write yourself an email campaign that you can simply copy and paste and send to your email subscribers. And like we're going to be doing here in this video, you can use ChatGPT to come up with a code for web development, web design, application development, and so on and so forth. And of course, in this video, we're going to be focusing on using the ThinkScript language and making ourselves some custom trading indicators with ChatGPT. So first and foremost, the one that I want to go over here is going to be for the RSI. The RSI, or the Relative Strength Index, tells us when a stock is overbought when it has an RSI of 70 or higher, or when it is oversold with an RSI of 30 or lower. Overbought and oversold levels, although they're not 100% accurate, when you pair them with other indicators and with the price action itself, they can be used to find reversal points in the stock market for us to base our entries and our exits off of. So simply put, to start off with this code, I simply asked ChatGPT to use the ThinkScript to write a code for an indicator that plots an arrow down when the RSI is above 70 and plots an arrow up when the RSI is below 30. It gave us this code, and once I plug this code into Thinkorswim, what we can see is that there is going to be a ton of arrows on this chart. Let's go ahead and look at the 5-minute chart, for example. We're looking at Tesla stock here, and I want to focus actually on yesterday's price action because Tesla had a big sell-off to the downside yesterday. So we can see that it remained oversold for a pretty extended period throughout the day. That's going to lead to pretty much every single candle here having an up arrow telling us that the stock is oversold. And although it is kind of cool to put this information into an artificial intelligence robot and have that robot create a code within 10 seconds that gives us this indicator on our charts, it's not going to be very useful for us. So I wanted to take this a step further. So the next thing that I did was I said to only plot an arrow if the current bar's volume is 2 times or more the previous bar's volume. And the reason for that is because volume exhaustion or high relative volume is also going to be an indicator of a potential reversal. So when you pair that with an oversold or an overbought level using the RSI, those two things together can hopefully give us a more accurate idea of when a stock is ready to reverse. So this gave us some code and there were some issues with the code. All I did was copy and paste the issues that I saw on Thinkorswim back into the ChatGPT. And it actually fixed up those issues right away, giving us a new code. And once that new code is plugged into Thinkorswim, you could see that there are obviously far less arrows here on this day. We get the first arrow up here at the open. And if I was using this to actually look for potential trades, I would not use it right out of the open because one of the criteria, of course, for this indicator is that there is going to be high relative volume when compared to the previous candle. And obviously that is going to be the case 100% of the time at the market open because that is when a substantial amount of volume comes in. But besides that first arrow, we get one more throughout the day, and that is all the way down here at about $105 per share. So we didn't get any indicators of a reversal all throughout this downtrend, which is a great sign because before we put in that volume criteria for this indicator, there were tons of false reversal signals all the way down as it fell over $10 per share. And this one gave us an indicator of a potential reversal at $105 per share. And it actually kind of nailed the exact bottom here. We can see that it bounced then from about 105 all the way up to over 109 later in the day. Let's go ahead and take a look at today's price action. We don't see any here on the 5-minute chart. Let's check out the 1-minute chart. And with the 1-minute chart, we can see that there were a few potential reversals here in pre-market. It bounced then from the 107s all the way up to about 113. Later on in the afternoon, this becomes overbought with strong relative volume coming in, and we can see there's a nice pullback from that level. The same thing happens a few hours later. It gets overbought. It does break a little bit above that level, but it does have a nice pullback towards the VWAP afterwards. And then towards the end of the day here, we get ourselves an oversold signal with high relative volume. And you can see that there was a nice bounce to follow up with that oversold indicator. So long story short, even though it is relatively simple, I think that this created a pretty solid reversal indicator just using the volume in the RSI, just by typing in some basic criteria into ChatGPT. Again, the script for this indicator, as well as all of the other ones that we're going to go over here throughout the rest of the video, can be found at the link down below in the description. So if you want to try these out yourself and put these onto your own charts to use for your own trading, you can feel free to do so. But moving on to the next one, this is going to be an exponential moving average crossover indicator. And the goal is for this to simply point an arrow to the upside when the 9 exponential moving average crosses above the 13 exponential moving average, and an arrow to the downside when it crosses below. So I asked ChatGPT for a code using that criteria. The first code that it gave didn't quite work, so I tried to rephrase it a little bit. I said, write a ThinkScript code for an indicator that plots an upward arrow only on the candlestick when the 9 EMA crosses above the 13 EMA, and a downward arrow only when the 9 EMA crosses below the 13 EMA. It gave me a revised version of the code, and once we go ahead and plug that onto our charts, we can see that it actually works fairly well. We have ChatGPT crossover added onto chart. And actually what you can do is you can go over to the settings icon here after you have this in your platform, and you'll be able to adjust the exponential moving average lengths. So instead of using the 9 and the 13, you could try different lengths if you prefer to do so. But we're going to go ahead and stick with 9 and 13 here. And if we go ahead and apply this to our charts, we can see we get a pink arrow to the downside when there is a crossover below, and a green arrow to the upside when there is a crossover above. And just to show you how well this actually works, let's go ahead and plug these exponential moving averages onto our chart. So we'll have a 9 moving average, and we will have a 13. And if we zoom in a bit here, actually, let me go ahead and change the colors here so we can tell the two apart. The 13 moving average is going to be in blue, and the 9 is going to be in green. So if we zoom in, we could see that we get ourselves a crossover to the upside here, right at the exact time that we get our arrow for the ChatGPT indicator. We get our exponential moving average crossover below right here, and that's going to give us our arrow pointing down from our ChatGPT indicator. So I will say that I really don't personally use moving averages very much in my own personal trading, but I know a lot of traders that do, and one of the most common strategies in regards to moving averages is to look for a shorter term moving average crossing above or below a longer term moving average. So this can be a really useful indicator for that reason. All right, now the third indicator that I wanted to create is going to simply tell us whether or not a stock has the short sale restriction activated. Short sale restriction comes into play when a stock, either the previous day or the current day, has fallen 10% or more below the previous day's closing price. And a lot of people think that a short sale restriction actually prevents short sellers from opening short positions entirely, but that is not true. Actually, what it does is it just prevents them from selling into the bid. And if they want to place an order to short sell, it's going to have to be above the current price. And what that does is it does prevent some people from taking short positions entirely, but if they do choose to short sell still, they're not able to sell into the bid and drive the price lower and lower and lower. So because of that, a short sale restriction can have a big effect on the way a stock is going to trade. And typically what you have to do is you have to find out what the previous day's closing price was, and then see whether or not it has fallen 10% or more below that price within the past trading day. And even though that is pretty simple, it would be nice to be able to just glance at your chart very quickly and see whether or not a stock is going to be short sale restricted. So that's what I was trying to do with this indicator. Now I tried time and time again. This is just one of the conversations that I had with ChatGPT. There were other ones that have been deleted, but I must have tried 50 different times or so you know, asking it in different phrases and trying to word it slightly different here and there for this very simple indicator. And for whatever reason, it was not able to give me the code that I was looking for. So unfortunately, in this case, ChatGPT kind of failed us with this indicator. So I had to go online and I searched up and found an indicator that was very similar to what I was looking for. And after making some slight adjustments of my own, we have ourselves an indicator that is going to simply tell us when a stock is short sale restricted. So if we apply this to the chart here, we can see that we're looking at the chart for IMVT. IMVT is currently down about 12% for the day. So obviously that is more than 10% below the previous day's closing price. And because of that, we can see that there is the short sale restriction, or SSR, active in the upper left corner of this chart. Let's take a look at SABR. This is another one that's down over 10% for the day. We see SSR active. Let's take a look at Kala. Now this is down 7.8%. So it's getting close to that short sale restriction, but it is not quite active yet. So we could see, obviously, it's not up in the upper left-hand corner of our charts just yet. Okay, so even though it wasn't quite able to give me what I was looking for this specific indicator, I think ChatGPT is a very useful tool. And the previous examples with the RSI and the exponential moving average crossovers prove that ChatGPT can be very useful when it comes to creating these custom indicators. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel. And remember that if you want to try these indicators out for yourself, you can go to the first link down below in the description. Obviously, I didn't come up with them on my own, so I'm in no position to charge for them. They are going to be 100% free. You just have to follow the link below and you'll be able to add them to your own charts. But anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And until next video, good luck with your trading.